Hi, my beautiful souls. How is everyone doing? Well, I am so excited to be here. Let me tell you, today is Austera. It is the first day of spring. And by the time you watch this video, it will not be this day. As you know, my videos are usually done ahead of time, and I put them in a storage bank and plan them for another occasion. However, I had to at least film today and share this with you on this beautiful spring equinox that we have right now today. The moon is full. It is a full moon. So many blessings to everyone, not only for Austera spring, but also for full moon. I am really, really having a great day today. Look at this. My hair is stuck in my glasses. Why? Oh, hang on. Why does this happen? Hold on. Whew, look at that. In my glasses. There we go. Okay. So I'm so excited, and you can probably tell by the clip that is on this video that I am holding a bouquet of flowers, because look what I have in my hair. I am so excited about these. This is my little yellow rose and my little pink rose hair clip that I made actually today. And I had a bunch of flowers left over in my stash from a previous Walmart and Dollar Tree haul that I know that you've already seen. Again, by the time that you see this video, you've already seen my spring equinox altar mantle tour, as well as the hauls that I did for Easter and Austera. And I had found the most beautiful roses at Walmart, in fact. And I think I might have purchased a few floral things also from Dollar Tree. But anyways, I had to go back today to Dollar Tree and Walmart because I used all of my flowers up already for some other spring crafting things that I'm doing for my trunk show that's coming up. But, and also for my altar that you saw in the tour. But I wanted to make more of these for my spring trunk show. Aren't these precious? I love them so much. And you know how I love to put things in my hair. I'm always wearing florals in my hair, little bows and flowers and things like that. So I thought, how sweet. I have my hair in a braid, and then I just have like the two different colors. And I think it's so pretty for spring. Being it the first day today, I had to dress up my hair and make it really, really festive for the equinox. So with that being said, I needed to pick up a few more bouquets so that I could make some more clips for my hair for my trunk show. So I went to Walmart, and at first I went to Dollar Tree because I couldn't remember where I got the roses from. And I wasn't finding these particular ones. And I thought, did they sell out of them? But I did also have to make a stop for a few household supplies at Walmart. And I saw that they were there for 97 cents. And that is where I purchased the ones that I'm using, not only in my hair, but the ones that I've used for some of the other crafted things that I've created for my spring trunk show. With that being said, I am in the process, and this video is going to kind of be a little mishmash of everything. I'm in the process of creating these adorable little clothespins, and you really can't see the color very well. The lighting is terrible in here. It is actually, oh, after 10 o'clock p.m. And so it's kind of dark. And so therefore the color is not going to be the greatest, but I am making these beautiful pink clothespins, beautiful robin egg blue clothespins. I have a pretty melon color clothespin and then a purple clothespin. And what I've been doing is I have been creating florals on top of the clothespins so that when you open them up, they display this beautiful flower, and you can make like a bunting and hang up Easter cards or any festive springtime arrangements or buntings that you want to hang. So I'm making those for my craft show. And also, if I have any leftover florals, I will be using them to dress up some of the clips. But in addition to that, I am painting a bunch of clips, different spring colors, and I'm going to be offering them just as is painted for purchase, because sometimes people just like them plain, or mine are going to be plain. They're going to be painted, but for springtime, like I said, to hang up buntings or cards, different things like that for the beautiful weather that we're going to be having coming very, very soon. It was pretty nice today in Pittsburgh, Pennsylvania, and I'm hoping for more beautiful days now that spring has finally arrived. But I also needed to get these flowers, like I said, for the hair clips that I will be making because I don't think I have any out right now. I don't. But anyways, I'm going to be creating them so that I can have also a beautiful little basket filled with hair florals to put in your hair. So I picked up this beautiful, lovely bouquet of pink roses, and these are the same color pink that is in my hair. I also picked up, and this is from Walmart, these beautiful yellow roses. And that is this up here. I really did not want to take apart what I have on my altar because I love how it looks there. And when I am moving things to place my my summer solstice mantle altar display for the next turn of the wheel of the year, I will be probably using some of those florals again. And even if I don't, I want to put them away so that I have them for the following year and years to come. It's late. Like I said, it's after 10. I've been up all day crafting and working around my home and in my studio, and I am getting tongue-tied. Whew. All right. So anyways, at Walmart, I also picked up one of my favorite glues. Those of you that work with me in the journal workshops and also follow some of my artistry know that I love to work with the Elmer's rubber cement when it comes to collage work on paper. This is the best glue, I think, out there for that because it gives you a lot of wiggle room. And that way, if you make a mistake, you can pick it up and replace it. And also, it holds a serious bond. And it's acid-free and photo-safe, dries clear, it's got a brush applicator, and honestly, it is really, really awesome. So what I recommend is getting this at Walmart because they have the best price. I have seen it at Target. It's not too bad at Target either. But Walmart, you can get this big jar. I recommend the 8-fluid-ounce jar, and it is, $3.97 in the... It's in the office supply section. If you find it in the crafting section, I don't believe that they have a jar this large. But anyways, look for it in the office supply section of Walmart for $3.97. You can't go wrong. If you have never used this glue before, you will absolutely adore it. Trust me. So I got that. Where am I going to put it? I'm going to put it there. And then for my florals and also for some slow stitching projects, I needed to get some felt. And these colors are just so beautiful and perfect for spring. So I picked up a spring green. I picked up this beautiful cream color. And I picked up a pale pink. And I will be using probably the pale pink on the pinks and the cream color on the yellow. The yellow that they had there in felt was a little bit too bright, and I didn't really think that it would go well. Now, on the ones that I made, I actually have the neon green, only because that is what I had in my stash that was handy and within my reach. So, and they're for me. So I just went ahead and used the neon green. It doesn't look bad. You can't even see them. No one's going to see it but me whenever the clip is out of my hair. So, not a problem, but for the ones that I will be selling, I want it to get somewhat coordinating colors to go with them. So that is what I got at Walmart. And excuse my reach there. Okay. And then at Dollar Tree, I got a few little goodies. Now, one of these things, I actually ended up buying two of them in different sayings because I had my eye on them the last time I was at the store and I passed it up and I know that they're not going to last very long. And I'm going to show you them first. And what they are little clips for your handbag. They're little keychains, but I'm not going to put my keys on them. I'm going to use them as a little attachment for my handbag. This is the current handbag that I'm using right now. And I'm probably going to do a what's in my handbag video as well to show you how much I am able to fit in this adorable little bag. I love this bag for spring. I got this at a thrift shop many, many years ago, and it is really perfect for any season, but I love it for spring. What I've been doing is I have been using this handbag for my grab and go, but I take this along inside my Vera Bradley gifted tote that I got for my birthday a couple years ago from my friend Amy. And I just throw everything that I need for the day. Like if you've seen my handbag videos before of what's in my handbag, I keep my journals. I keep my reading book that I'm going to be reading. I keep pens and all sorts of like extra pens and things like that. And it's so much to carry. And I was carrying it in this beautiful brown and blue handbag that I know you've seen in a thrift shop haul before. And I love that bag, but it was getting so heavy on my shoulder. I just couldn't stand it anymore. So I needed to make a change. And the tote bag, everything is distributed so wonderfully within the bag. So it's not hurting my shoulder at all, but I needed a grab and go because the tote bag is so large. I used to actually carry it as my handbag, but I don't really need all of that stuff all the time. So just leaving it in my vehicle is perfect and grabbing and going with this is what I'm doing. So I got these and I couldn't decide, like I said, so I did pick up two and I'm pretty sure these are from Wonder Woman, but I'm not positive. Let me know in the comments. So I first got this one and it's a green felted little keychain. Wait a minute, let me get this out of the way. And the front says, BAM, in pink. It's so adorable. It's so sparkly and shiny. And I had to get it because just the other day we were at band practice and I said something. I forget what it was that I said, but I was like, BAM. And I thought, oh my gosh, I've got to get to the Dollar Tree and get that keychain that I saw because I know they're going to go and it's just like so perfect. And let me show you how adorable it looks. I haven't cut the tag off yet, but it also has, well, wait a second. Let me show you this. It also has a lobster claw clasp, which is fabulous. And if you were to hold your keys on it, it has the key ring. And it also has this cute little faux leather tassel. Isn't that adorable? So cute. And lastly, this cute little, it's not a jingle bell, but it's just like a little golden ball. So I love it. And this is what it looks like if it were to be hanging. Visualize it without the tag, people. But look how cute that is. Is that not the cutest? The colors match my bag so perfectly. And then I had to get this one too, because you know how much I love the color pink. This one has the pink felted on the back and it has the pink little faux leather tassel along with the gold ball, lobster claw clasp, the key ring, and this one says POW. It's kind of hard to see in this lighting. I don't know if you'll be able to tell, but it says POW. And that also is so super cool. And look how this one looks. They both are so cute. I couldn't decide. So I ended up getting both because if I want to change it up and make it pink, I can do this one. If I want to have the green, I can go with the green. It's so cute. I so love it. I've even considered putting both of them together and kind of cascading them. And I might end up doing that because the gypsy in me, loves to have all sorts of stuff on all the time. You know me, I do like 4 necklaces at a time, tons of bracelets and all of that. So I thought maybe I could lobster claw this to maybe like that, and then have both of them hanging on my bag. And that's probably what I'm going to do because they're just so super cute. That's from the Dollar Tree. And if you love those, I highly recommend you running to the Dollar Tree as fast as possible and getting them. Then I got these beautiful pink roses, and these are darker than the ones I get at Walmart, as you can see. So I have the option to create a couple different shades of pink in the hair bows that I will be offering at my spring show. And, I want to show you something else too before we close this video. I also got from the Dollar Tree this floral wire, and the color didn't matter to me which color I got, because what I'm going to be using these for is my boho bracelets that I'm not going to be offering at this spring show because I probably won't have time to prepare them. I have a lot of other projects that I'm working on for the show, but I am preparing for Christmas in July as well as my fall trunk shows, and I'm going to be adding, mainly for my fall trunk shows, I'm getting back to incorporating my jewelry line of my enchanting gypsy and goddess type of jewelry pieces into my my shows. And I'm going to be doing a lot of fiber art type of jewelry for my upcoming shows. So I needed this bracelet, this wire for the bracelets that I have in mind, because they need to be, they're bangles and they need to be stretchy so that they can fit different size wrists and still, you know, they could be scrunched if need be. With the fabric on it, it wouldn't matter and you wouldn't be able to tell that they were scrunched to fit the wrist better. Or they could be expanded if they were purchased by somebody with a larger wrist. So I got that. And lastly, I got this wonderful Lucite tray for my desk to put different little things in that I have in my desk drawer. And I probably will end up getting several more of these because I think these are fabulous. I want to try it first and see what it looks like in my desk. And I might even have room for several of them in my desk, so we'll see. Hopefully they will still have these when I get back. But that is what I got from the Dollar Tree. And I wanted to also show you what I've been working on today in my studio. And if you follow me on Instagram and my artist page, Milady Lila, on Facebook, I know that you have seen this. I not only posted it in my feed on Instagram, but I also posted it as a story. I'm currently working on this. These are little boards that are going to be folded and placed into a journal that I'm creating. And I talked about this journal. Let me reach for it. I talked about this journal in the current journal workshop group that we did for March. And this is the journal that I am creating. It is right here. Actually, this is what it looks like. And this is the inside so far. I have a lot of work to do yet. But these right here are going to be the pages inside to each signature. There's going to be other embellishments and things like that inside here. But these are going to be the part of the signatures. I'm going to have 4 signatures. And they're mainly going to be housing these beautiful cards that I got a long time ago at the Dollar Tree. It was a game called Belisara. And apparently they no longer make these cards. I don't even know if the game is still, I think you can still go to belisara.com and you still might, but I'm not sure. You still might be able to get to it and play the game. Let me see if that's the right website. Yes, Bella, as in Sam, ARA.com, or S as in Sarah. And it's your ticket to the world of Bella Sara. What it is they're these beautiful cards. They're very whimsical, of horses and castles and things. And they're almost like little mini tarot cards. And they have a beautiful message on each card. And apparently you can win things like crystals and different things within the game. I don't really know how that works. I'm not a gamer, and my children are all grown up, and my grandkids might, well, my granddaughter might be interested in this game, but we never really talked about it. So I'm gonna have to talk to her about it and see. But anyways, what I'm going to be doing is, I thought these cards were so lovely, and I'm going to be incorporating them somehow into a journal and making the journal a whimsical kind of mystical journal. I'm going to include this picture of a unicorn and use a lot of purples and pinks and whites and a lot of sparkle, you know, sparkle and shine to it. I also have a piece of vintage fabric that I will be incorporating somehow into. This is a beautiful powder blue with this vintage lace sewn on the bottom. So I will be incorporating that somehow. And then from the same piece that I cut this fabric from, I have two of these. This was actually part of the tie, because the fabric piece was actually a bed jacket a long time ago, and it was mine from, gosh, way back. I had it like in the 80s. So it is vintage. And I'm going to be using these to probably incorporate tying the journal. So I'm very excited about that. And that is a project that I've been working on. So that's what I was doing today, creating those. And lastly, I want to show you this beautiful banner that I put together for, let me get this out of the way, for my trunk show that is coming up. And hopefully you can see it. Let me grab it. So this is going to be my banner that is going to go above my table at my trunk show. It says Milady Lila Enterprises, live life beautifully, MiladyLila.com. And this image right here is the image that I have on my brand new business cards. And it is currently on a piece of foam core that I got at the Dollar Tree. Now the signage is actually larger than the board. So what I did was I just folded it over. No one's going to see the back. And I decided temporarily to use some of my painted clothespins to tack it on, so that if I decide to make it permanent on something and size it appropriately, I can just take it off this board and do so. And then also down here on the bottom, I have these adorable little clips that were gifted to me and some happy mail from my friend. Again, like I said, I can't even talk. My friend Meg from YouTube, she's Elizabeth Story here on YouTube, and she had gifted me in some happy mail a couple of these beautiful black clothespins with little roses on them. So I thought that that was like the perfect accompaniment for putting this all together. And I absolutely love and adore it. I think it's going to be perfect for my shows. So let me just put that back. Okay. And it's down here. Okay. So let's see what else is going on. Oh, so I'm sure those of you that have just watch this video might want to see what's in my handbag. So I'm going to go ahead and I'm going to film that video. And whenever this video is posted, I do two postings, sometimes three postings within the week. So this particular week, whenever this video goes up, you can go ahead and look for the second video in the week of what's in my handbag. So stay tuned for that. I hope that you had a beautiful spring day on the very first day of spring. And I hope that it made you happy in knowing that our earth is ready to arise in glorious greenery and flowers. So have a beautiful spring, And I will be talking to you throughout, as you know. Well, you're not going to even see this video, like I said, until after the equinox, but stay tuned for more coming from my channel. And I love you all so much. Thank you so much for being with me. It's always a pleasure to hang out and spend time with you. I wish you so much love, many blessings, and many friendships to come. And I'll see you all in my next video. Bye.